Testing 1, 2, 3, Ichini Senchi. All right, we're live. Hi, guys. Welcome back to VR Essential, your go-to place for all that is related to the practical uses of virtual reality. And I'd like to welcome you if you're new to the channel, and a huge welcome back, of course, to all our regular viewers and awesome subscribers. Now, today, Meta, which is no longer known as Facebook, as Facebook will now become the subsidiary of Meta, do go and check out the previous video, which I uploaded not too long ago, has announced a new VR headset, which they will be releasing in 2022, which will not be the Oculus Quest part of that name's family, but will be called something else, which is codename Project Cambria. So let's move on, let's transition over to the other screen, and let's check out what all this means.
So what do you think is the most exciting thing that we're working on right now?
That's hard to say. You know, we have such an exciting pipeline. But next year, we are releasing a new product that'll push the boundaries of VR even further. We've codenamed it Project Cambria.
So this isn't the next Quest. It's going to be compatible with Quest. But Cambria will be a completely new, advanced, and high-end product, and it'll be at the higher end of the price spectrum, too. Our plan here is to keep building out this product line to release our most advanced technology before we can hit the price points that we target with Quest. All right, so let's talk about some of the new advances here.
Yeah.
So basically, this new headset is looking to be more expensive. Now, recently, Pimax announced that they're going to be releasing a new headset worth more than $2,000. We also know that Apple are looking to release a headset that will be more than $1,000, potentially $2,000 as well. Varjo have just come into the game. Normally they charge $5,000 or $6,000. Now they're charging $2,000 as well. Excuse me, it's very late. It's about 1 o'clock in the morning or 2 o'clock in the morning, 3 o'clock in the morning here in Singapore. You know, and also Valve will be releasing a new headset next year, which will most probably be between $600 to maybe $1,000+. Pico also charging about $600 up to $900 as well. So, you know, we know there's a market for higher end consumer VR headsets or prosumer VR headsets. So, you know, that's where they're going to go. Now, here are some of the features that they're going to be having on this VR headset.
Yeah, sure. There's a ton of new tech going into Cambria. For example, your avatar will be able to make natural eye contact and reflect your facial expressions in real time. This way, people you're interacting with will have a real sense of how you're actually feeling.
So we know that facial tracking is something that is coming into various different headsets. Deca Gear are working on a PC VR headset that does that. HTC released an accessory tracker which can do that as well. And then there are various other technologies around that can also do this. So now Meta or Facebook, you know, we're very concerned about the privacy data that they mine, that they take from us, that they then give back to third parties, although allegedly on the privacy policy page it states that they don't share the data. However, we do know that that data is used to change the fabric of society and also implement thoughts into our brain subliminally. So there's a lot of questions here to be asked. I do hope that with the rebranding of Meta, it means that the strategy will also be different. Let's always give benefit of doubt, right? But here are some of the other features that they spoke about in this video.
It does mean building more sensors into a form factor that's comfortable to wear for a while. And because we want VR to be for everyone, we also have to make sure avatars represent a diverse set of human facial features and skin tones, as well as paying attention to things like glasses and beards that may get in the way of some of the sensors.
So that's going to be a big step forward for social presence, and I'm really glad that we're focused on making it inclusive from the start. Now, what about unlocking more mixed reality experiences? I mean, imagine working at your virtual desk with multiple screens while seeing your real desk so clearly that you can pick up a pen and write notes without taking your headset off. Or, you know, you're doing a workout with a virtual instructor in your living room.
It's going to be so cool.
So mixed reality, of course, is something that, you know, is going to become more and more predominant within the industry as VR evolves, because VR will become XR eventually, basically, where you can interact with augmented reality as well as being immersed in a virtual reality world. So it's called XR. Lynx R1 already doing this. They're the world's first. We posted a video on the channel. Do go and check out this video. It has all the information there. And I also like the hand tracking gestures, tracking technology that, you know, they're showing in this video. Do go and check out the previous video about Ultra Leap, who just released the world's best hand tracking technology yesterday, literally, called Gemini. Do go and check out this video. It's on the channel as well. It was posted a few hours ago. Very interesting. A lot of insights in that video too. And of course, the ability not to remove your VR headset anymore, so that the pass-through technology is in color, and also not just in color, but in 4K or 8K. It's so crisp and clear that you would forget that your headset's on your head. And also, hopefully by then, because the Oculus Quest 2 at the moment is about 500 grams, will become 300 grams. Why not? That would be fantastic. So I think this is where they're looking to head. So let's check out the rest of the video.
Potentials of these kinds of experiences today as people are building for a pass-through API. But with Cambria, we'll be taking this to the next level with high-resolution, colored, mixed reality pass-through. We essentially combine an array of sensors with reconstruction algorithms to represent your physical world in the headset with a sense of depth and perspective. Now, we're still a ways away from exactly matching what our eyes see in the physical world, but we're pretty encouraged by how far we've been able to advance the pass-through experience so far.
Definitely, but we also need to push the visuals to the next level. So let's talk about the...
So just to give you an idea that the pass-through at the moment is in black and white, and it's actually pretty bad. It's very pixelated. It's not super clear. So this would be quite a feat in the world of VR.
Progress that we're making on optics.
Yeah, we're pushing the limits of display technology and form factor with something called pancake optics. They essentially work by folding light several times over to achieve a slimmer profile than current lenses. Now, with several optical layers, we'll need to precisely control every aspect of design and fabrication to achieve that high-quality, artifact-free display and really just deliver the best optics ever in one of our headsets.
So this is going to be very challenging because at the moment, a lot of manufacturers, including Lynx, with the Lynx R1, they have very thick lenses and they use software to basically make it so that whatever you see is flat inside and there's no distortion around the lenses. Same thing with Varjo, who do similar things using software, but unfortunately at the moment there still is distortion even in those super high-end headsets. You know, it's still there. So this is going to be something that's going to be quite interesting to see. Also, we'll have to know whether they're going to be using OLED or LCD, because OLED provides a crisper, sharper kind of technology when you for the pixel density and the pixels you're looking at. The colors sharper, the actual pixels themselves are sharper, and also the colors are more contrasty, so the blacks are very black and the brights are more bright. So it's a bit like HDR kind of feel. And the new Pimax, they're using a complete new set of technologies. Do go and check out that video which we posted yesterday about it, which really looks like it's going to offer amazing clarity as a VR experience. Let's continue the video.
Pretty awesome. But let's make sure that we leave some of the good stuff for next year's release too. All right, now I'm excited to keep building out this new product line over future generations so we can keep getting our most advanced technology into people's hands even before we can get it into our Quest product line.
That's our goal. We're starting to work with developers to build experiences for Cambria.
So basically what they do is, generally speaking, they actually release some of the technologies in their current products. So those who own an Oculus, a Facebook Meta Quest 2, will get to sample some of those advanced technologies in a beta mode. And then when they release Cambria, whatever it will be called back then, because I doubt it will be called, it's a code name at the moment, then basically what will happen is, you know, they will then sample the full features of the headset. Now also, we are anticipating a Quest 2 Pro, so something in between what's available today and the Cambria project. So let's see if they're going to announce anything this year about this. But I'd just like to say before we leave the video, it's very strange how Cambria sounds very much like Cambridge Analytica. I don't know whether there's a similarity there or not. I think it's very coincidental and quite funny that they decide to codename a project Cambria, which is so close to Cambridge Analytica, all the scandals that they had about that. I would have opted for a codename that has nothing to do or wouldn't even subliminally remind me of that phase of the Facebook or Meta saga. Anyway, it is always quite funny. Guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. Remember to like, share, subscribe, enable the bell, and reshare this video in all your social media, on LinkedIn, on Facebook, on Reddit, on Twitter, and all that it is, because we are at nearly 10,000 subscribers, guys. And as you know, the more subscribers we get, then I can give back to you. The hardware manufacturers can send us all the gear to test out. We can do giveaways of keys, of hardware, and more. So guys, I'll see you in another video very shortly, providing you news and insights of the virtual reality industry. Ciao. See you later.